For years now, I went in for my usual monthly tune-up, a nip here, a tuck there. This particular day, though, I was feeling extra saggy. I asked him to pump up my bum just a little something something. To my surprise, he said, "Sorry, Georgette, I'd have to cut you open for that. You need another appointment." Oh, he didn't want to cut me open? Well, as he was washing his hands, I grabbed his scalpel. You know, I think I might have to find a new doctor. He had shortcomings. He had no sense. He had no chin. If you're a scamp in my position, you know that I'm not the one to blame.
When I was a little girl, I was Papa's princess. I got everything I wanted. Even if I got a no at first, all I had to do was smile. But one day we were at Swarovski and there was this crystal necklace I wanted. I asked once, "No, sweetie." I asked twice, "I'm sorry, sweetie, no." I asked a third time with my smile, "Marsha," I said, "no." Well, since he expected me to accept no as an answer, I expected him to accept me burning down the house with him in it.
I'm the marker to my polo. But see, my manager, he said to me, to make in this industry, I need a man up under me, cause the ladies just don't bring the heat. So I wrapped his ass up in a blanket before I threw him in the East River. You warm yet? You are standing in my position. You know that I'm being the one to blame.
Hey, Julie. Swedish au pair. I worked for a wonderful family in America taking care of their little boy, Tim. He was cute, but so, so mean. Every day I would say, "Tim, clean your room," or "Tim, clear your plate." And every time he would say, "Eat me, bitch." They usually let it slide, but one day I saw he ate all of my Swedish fish, or as I say, fish. "Tim, you ate all of my fish. Eat me, bitch." Well, that night I decided to finally grant his wish. American boys sure are tender.
I was looking to enter a relationship. Local men just have no mystique. One night, as I sat alone in my apartment sipping a white Russian, I decided to go down to the corner bar. I noticed the bartender as soon as I walked in. Charming, tall, but eh. He came over and asked me what I wanted. White Russian. Here I am. Hello. His name was Vlad, from Moscow. I took him back to my place for a nightcap, plus a morning screwdriver. As he showered, I accidentally found his wallet and glanced at his ID. Vlad? Moscow? More like Jack from Chattanooga. It wasn't until I heard them scraping his body off the concrete that I remembered I left my window open.
He has a coming, he has a coming.
Tempted before by pancakes, sure, but never by a man. But my male manager, so doggone fine, he always comes by at 1:34 p.m. to drop off my packages. Oh, look, it's 1:34. Hey, Minister Deborah, got another one for you. Got any other packages for me today? Well, one thing led to another, and before I knew it, he was delivering me straight to the devil. It was the most erotic moment of my life. Man, do you know, at 1:34 p.m., he delivered me a knife.
They were dumb, 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 dumb,
aggression.
Delivered.